Welcome to Pi System Basics, an online course designed to give you a broad overview of the Pi system. My name is Jeff Resnick. I'm an e-learning specialist at OSI Soft, and most of my responsibilities involve the YouTube learning channel, as well as our learning website. More on those to come. This course is designed for people who are new to the Pi system, or beginners with working with OSI Soft in general. You may be wondering, what can you do with the Pi system? In this course, we're going to walk through a full example of one of the ways that our customers are currently using the Pi system today. We'll also talk about all the different Pi system tools and components that come with the package, so you'll know whether you need to focus on collecting your data, storing and enhancing your data, or delivering it to your end users. We'll also talk about how to get started. So whether it's the basics of learning Pi time, what a Pi tag or Pi point is, what an AF attribute is, we'll cover all of this in the course. At the end of the course, we'll make sure that you know where to go to learn more. These include our learning website, our OSI Soft Learning YouTube channel, the My OSI Soft customer portal, including all of tech support, as well as the Pi Square community. Nowadays, data is everywhere. There's lots of sources of data, and this can mean that it's difficult to figure out what pieces of data are relevant to you. As organizations continue to grow, their data needs are going to grow too. Let's take a look at some of the stakeholders that need data to do their job well and to keep operations running smoothly. We have engineers who are minimizing downtime. They need to see data in real time to correct an issue with the process. There's a business analyst calculating plan efficiency with data from three different sources. Normally, you'd have to email engineers from different departments and hook into their respective historians to extract spreadsheets, which may be in different formats. He would spend hours reformatting and massaging the spreadsheets before he realizes that an engineer sent him the wrong data and he has to start all over again. Does any of this sound familiar to you? An operator needs to make sure that their process is healthy at all times. That's fine while they're on site, but what happens if they leave? What happens if an incident occurs if they're not on call? And we have a maintenance engineer who needs to know when the process goes out of tune, no matter where she is. These questions or pains might sound familiar to you in your role, or you might have completely different questions and concerns. The good thing about the Pi system is that anyone can access the data. Managers, scientists, engineers, analysts, even accountants commonly go to the Pi system for up-to-date process data or historical data for post-hoc analysis. As long as the data exists, you can use the Pi system to your advantage. Think about where your data comes from. How does it get from the instrumentation to the screen on your computer? What data is critical to you and your job? Keep your own use cases in mind as you progress through this course.